with almost a million people to police in the county and more than 500 999 calls every day, the Bodycam squad are always prepared for anything.
Well, so far it's been fairly quiet on the radio. I've not been into the city yet, so I don't know how busy the city centre will be.
It's 7 p.m. and PC Carl Brown and his crew are starting the night shift in Nottingham city centre.
I think the weather will have a big play on how busy town will be tonight. It's a Friday evening and it's a pay weekend for most people.
Despite sub-zero temperatures, calls to the police are still coming through.
Well, we've just had a call from Marks and Spencers in the city centre. They've stated the male has caused some damage in the toilets. He spray-painted the toilets green.
Carl's been policing for nearly 17 years and knows the characters in the city centre so well that he has a good idea who he's looking for.
The description matches a local male. He's fairly well known to us. He easily stands out, so it shouldn't be too hard to spot if he's in the city centre.
The man Carl thinks could be responsible for the criminal damage is a notorious local character everyone knows as the Joker.
He's a known local beggar, and with it being pay weekend, I would suspect that he's going to be looking to be on the streets begging and as people are going to have money in the pockets.
Carl is on first name terms with most of the homeless people in the city and tries to get a lead on the suspect.
Have you seen the Joker?
I ain't seen him. Are you looking for him, are you?
Yeah.
I'll let him know you're looking for him. I'll see you down here. All right.
Cheers, pal. I suspect he's going to be in the city centre somewhere. It's just finding out where.
Carl's determined to find the man suspected of spray painting the toilet floor of a shop.
Hey, have you seen the Joker?
Oh, he was in Halifax for Halifax
today.
Bank. Mm.
Today.
I was.
Have you seen him in the last 20 minutes, half an hour?
Oh, I haven't.
Listen, no. Broadway Centre, they've got a night shelter there, so get yourself there.
Is it only 2 or 3 minutes walk?
Yeah, literally left there, into the top. And then that's Broad Street, yeah? Okay.
Good man.
All right, get yourself out of the cold. Right.
Everyone knows who Carl's referring to, and his search could be closing in.
Yeah, no, walk, it's Kane, innit?
Yeah,
look that way, mate.
Right. Where that bus is now, 78.
Yeah. 71. Oh, is that, oh, that's him, yeah, that's him.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
There you go.
He's certainly distinctive, but his grin's about to be wiped off his face.
Nowhere, why?
Anywhere?
No. Do you want to jump on our van? We'll ask some questions, is that right?
Yeah, you can.
Come on,
do.
Mate. Come with us, buddy.
Now, can I ask what this is regarding?
There's been an allegation that you've caused some damage at Marks and Spencer's in Broadmarsh.
Marks and Spencer's?
Yeah.
What damage is that?
Apparently spray-painted in the toilets.
Oh, you know what? I did. I spray-painted my shoes, but I didn't mean to cause any damage, mate.
Right, OK.
He's been caught red, or rather green-handed. But Carl knows this man is no joke for the cops.
He can be abusive and sometimes become violent. Yeah, I mean, on this day, he was quite sober.
The damage has been caused on purpose. He said the floor's been spray-painted.
Nah, I spray-painted my shoes, man.
He said it was an accident, basically. He said he was spray-painting his boots green as part of his costume. He proper goes to town with it. When he's begging on the streets, it's something that kind of grabs a bit of attention.
Before they can arrest the Joker, they need to take a formal statement from the store.
If we haven't got a complaint, there's not a lot we can do tonight, but, yeah,
so
we'll see if the caller will
come and
meet us and
we'll
contact him.
That's not fair, man.
The Joker's not keen on going to custody, as he'll be away from his begging spot on payday, one of his most profitable nights of the month.
No, listen, leave me out on the street tonight and let me call
you. No, we can't,
the
because you're committing an offence, haven't you?
Tomorrow.
I'll sit down with you, mate.
But you're homeless, aren't you, at the moment? Have you got an address?
Dave,
yeah,
man.
But
like,
I know, but because
an update comes through from control.
Yeah, that's received.
All staff at the store have left for the night, including the person who made the complaint. The Joker won't be going to custody, but Carl offers him an option that appeases them both.
We're going to take you to St. Anne's and voluntary interview you, OK?
Thank you. Yeah.
All right.
That's good.
What's that going to take?
It won't take long, mate. Half an hour. There's not a lot we can do tonight. The store's shut, so we can't take a statement from the store. We don't, at this stage, have any reason to detain him, so it will just be a voluntary interview. It's quite a good way of resolving things, really. It's a thing that we do quite a lot now, voluntary interview people where we can.
As they can't arrest the Joker tonight, he'll be back out on the street once the interview's over.
I figure rather than just coming into town dressed homeless and looking like a down and out, wanting to try and raise up some money, I think I'll try and do something which is appealing to the eye. Not everybody finds the Joker appealing, but I don't do it for everybody. I do it for the people that like a rogue or like a villain. Because at the end of the day, that's what I am. I am a villain, so I might as well be what I am. And then, you know what, in this country, the letter of the law says as long as you're not being dishonest, you're not committing a crime. And I figure if I'm dressing like the Joker and I'm dressing as a villain, I should be allowed to be a villain and get away with it.
But the Joker must have had a change of heart, as when it came to court, he pleaded guilty to criminal damage. This was taken into account by the judge, and he was given a conditional discharge for 6 months, which means if he commits another offence in that time, he could be sentenced for the first offence and the new one.